start off, I'm going to go ahead and just show you guys some of the stuff. This is a the Mazdem power pole. It's a 2-ton capacity. So 4,000 pound capacity. And this actually is the older style. Apparently there's a newer style, and I saw the difference online. Somebody did a review on this guy, and there's some very subtle differences, but one of them is the release mechanism here is a little wider on the newer one. So it's a little different in that regard. But these have some really nice forged, and it does say USA on them. So I think these are actually, this is considered the better of the bunch. But this is definitely a nice come along, and I don't have a come along, so that's really cool. You saw me using this guy, and this is an awesome little tool. I had this part, but I did get another one from the job site. However, it didn't have this on it, so I just took this part, put it on. But this is an amazing attachment. You just put this right on your compressor fitting, and it basically makes it into an extension wand, but it increases the airflow. So if you were wondering the advantage, it's not only is it cool because you can get into tight spots, and with that angle on it, you can get into around the corner, but it actually increases the airflow pretty dramatically, actually. All right, so this guy was new in the packaging. I actually used this on a job. This is a basically a template gauge. You can go and you can measure the angle of stuff like walls or whatnot. And this is actually very useful for setting countertops. So if you put a countertop or floating shelves or stair treads, you can definitely use this type of tool. And I actually don't have this. So when I saw this, I was like, man, that's really cool. I have a contour gauge, but to the extent of, this type of thing, I normally just use pieces of wood, put it in the corner, and glue them together. But with this one, it's nice because you can just, angle it to the wall and then tighten it up and then go and trace it out to cut it on your wood. So this is actually really cool. And this literally was in the packaging, never used. So I think this was purchased at a Home Depot. Very cool. This actually is very neat. I have two of these already, and these are the F14s, 20. This is a F11. Yeah, F14. I don't know. Anyways, this is the heavy duty one. These are great. Deep reach. So if you need something to hold, this is actually very, very strong. These aren't like my little Bessies. These were in there as well. So these are some DeWalt, quick grip style. They're just little ones. Not little, but not the big ones, but the in between. This is a little bit bigger. And again, these things were basically brand new. Look at these things. Haven't hardly been used. This, I think, has a release mechanism. So I'm not familiar with these DeWalt ones. All I know is I have my my quick grips, but this has like a quick release. So that's a really cool feature. So you can take it off without having to do a bunch of stuff to get it to become a spreader, right? So you would take that off, put that down there, and if you take this, put it around, now you have a spreader. So that's an instant, modification you can make with that tool. So that's really neat, right? I think that's a really cool idea to have that push button quick grip. You have to flip them around because they won't work because that pin kind of keeps them in the right location. And then that locks in. So again, really cool. A pair of, these are brand new. I mean, vice grips. This is absolutely These are phenomenal, absolutely, wire cutters and strippers. This guy here, I took the tag off of it. It was brand new. Pittsburgh, 1 pound rubber mallet. Those are always nice. And this guy here, this is a pry bar, nail puller, that sort of thing. Hammer, you can do lots of things. Basically, this is just a multi-tool. This is a DeWalt, it's actually really nice. These things, man, look at these. These are some really nice cobalt with some really good motion on these. You get a lot of torque with these wire cutters. So these are like diagonals, but they're a little different in that they have that nice action to them. So I don't have a pair like this that are just like that. So I'm pretty excited about that. This is really neat. I don't have one of these. I did not have one of these. So this is definitely a cool item. This is a drafting. So this is a Staedtler. You can see right there. Metric and Imperial. But it's a ruler that, you know, you can use to go around things, to measure around stuff. Really cool. And again, something I didn't have before. This guy here, it's actually on one of the things I'll show you in a little bit, and that is a miter gauge. The thing that it's on is like a multi-router. So that goes to that. It's a multi-router. It's a homemade one. It's pretty cool. I'll show it to you in a little bit. This guy here, right? Everybody knows what that is. So this is a half-inch drive to a hex shank for your drill, socket adapter. And these probably one of my favorite finds. This is a Veritas setup gauge. Oh, I love this thing. So this is a 1-2-3 block, setup block with a 3/4 half. And then this is the primary one. So you get a quarter, you get an eighth, and you get a 1/16. And you can get additional 30 seconds or 16th inch ones, so you can add on to that set. You saw me use this, and this guy here, this is the original 250 Handyman Drill Doctor. This is the original, and I found it with this in a box, and I thought, man, I'm gonna do that. I sharpened like 4 drill bits. Amazing. This was the very first one they came out with. Thing works like a, runs like a top. And this thing, if you don't know what this is actually a Bridge City Toolworks MP8 machine protractor. So MP8's the model number. It's a machine protractor. You can do a lot of things with this. Certainly set up tools. You can set up putting this in your drill chuck on your drill press and getting the exact angle, making sure that everything is set up properly. But you can use it for other things too. In fact, if you want to find the center of squares, you could put that little guy right in there. This is a really unique tool, and this is an expensive tool. They don't make it anymore, so you got to find it on eBay or collectors. But this was over $100 new. And you might find it's actually more than $100 nowadays just for this guy right here. And take the dust off of it. Everything he had was just completely full of dust. So that is an amazing tool and just a great find. The next thing I'm going to show you is a couple things here. I'm going to grab and I'll be right back. Okay, trying to make room for all this stuff. All right, so the next thing I'm gonna go over, I got lots of planes, block planes, hand planes. So this guy made some custom hand planes, and when you make these, it's really important to have good steel. Otherwise, you know, your planes are kind of not so great. This guy here is just the body. The plane iron is actually not in there. So it's got the wedge. This one's got, everything is completely set. I actually set this up. It's a really nice blade. Let me see here. Hock, H-O-C-K. Very nice tool. Let me move on. We've got another hand plane. This is a very, very nice, again, everything he made is just beautiful. So this has got the same very nice steel in here. The only thing that this doesn't have is the wedge. So if you take the wedge and you put it in here, just like that, it'll actually stop the blade. Wherever you have the blade, it'll actually put you in your right position. So basically you just take it and you squeeze it in there. This doesn't fit because it's not the right one, but you get the idea. And what you can do is just make your own. But this one has a chip breaker as well, and it's again that same Hock steel in there. So see that right there? And it has a chip breaker. Very cool. But these things are just super. I just love the fact that this guy has these and created these. Okay, one thing, this 1-3 cord here, extension cord, these are always great, right? I mean, you see those, doesn't have any rips or kinks or, breaks, no tears in the rubber, so that's always nice. All right, look at this bad boy. This is the FR350 framing nailer, and I actually did use it, and it works. 3.5-inch framing nailer. It does have a leak down here. It's not much, but it is a leak. So I may do I put a new gasket on there. It's just a little gasket that goes around there. I don't think there's air coming out of any other place, but it does need to be cleaned. You can see, I mean, everything this guy owned is a mess. And this is, the same way. I need to clean that. It's amazing what things do look like when you clean them, but that's a monster. I don't have a framing nailer, so that's great. The guy had like 8 compressors too. Really nice ones, in fact. All right, more hand planes. This is a Weiss and Sohn. This is a classic, basically. These planes are collector's items, and this is one of the companies that are still around. They've been around for a long time, and they make planes for all different purposes. And this particular one is a standard, plane. It's flat. Some of them have a gouge contour like this one does. You can see that it's rounded. So it's basically going to scoop it. It's got the number and the size. And you can look in the books and you can see the catalog, and you can come across these, but they're all the same. And again, look at all the dust. But that's a rabbiting plane, another rabbiting plane. And again, the numbers are on the back, 3/4 inch. And now check this out. Look at this bad boy. Now, this is a phenomenal tool. This is a record, number 76. And this particular guy I used to fit the router lift over there in the router table, just to take a little bit off the inside rabbet for the drop-in, the lift. It wasn't quite right, so I just, trimmed just a little bit out of there. It's amazing, this tool. So I love it. So this is a bullnose rabbeting plane, and it gets really close up to the front. Some people call them chisel planes. This is a great tool. And again, very, very collector's item, oriented. These things here, this is the number 42 rabbiting plane. Again, just tremendous. These guys are phenomenal. I cannot believe I found all these. And this is a spoke shave. And this is a record. Excuse me. Oh my gosh. All right, so this is an A151 England record. Oh, this is just a sweet tool. I mean, look at how nice that is. So you can work with this guy to remove lots of material quickly off of lots of different items. Many different people like to use those for all sorts of things. And look at this, two cherries, beautiful. This is a carving knife. I call it a marking knife. It's listed as a carving knife, but essentially, yeah, two cherries, that's a nice one. Those things, if you find them on eBay, these things are running anywhere from like 50 to 100 bucks just for that one tool. And look at this. So this, I can't figure out who makes this. I'm pretty sure I did a research on it, but it's hard to find. But this guy's a razor saw, and this is a phenomenal saw. You saw me cut the molding at the job site the other day with this thing, and it just cuts it so nicely. Oh, it's just a great tool. Super sharp, and it's super fine, so it leaves like no curve. I mean, it's tiny, and it's really a rigid blade. Oh, look at this. And it's still going. And it's still going. So that says Veritas on the back there. This is a Veritas hand plane. This is a standard hand plane. This is not the low angle hand plane. This is a standard. And this is a beautiful plane. And I've always wanted a Veritas hand plane. And I just never bought one. I have Stanleys and I always used them. Oh, this is a sweet one. I can't wait to get the blades all sharpened in this. And then, yeah, we're still going. Look at this big joiner plane. So this guy is a monster. And again, that same Hawk blade. And tell me if I'm pronouncing that wrong. Hoke or Hawk? I don't know. It's. I think it's Hawk. But I do know that I've heard they're the best for these type of planes. But look at the finish on this. So clearly this guy's got a bunch of different woods here, but it's just an amazing, beautiful tool that this guy had created. And I'm assuming he created it because it doesn't have any markings on this. I'm pretty sure this is a hand-built by him blade. I mean, joiner plane. Now, let me take you over to the section over here. You'll see a router base for one of the routers that I got, and I'll show that to you later. So that's in the actual radial arm saw, and it's obviously not a radial arm saw anymore. It's a router that you can use for a tenoning router. You can cut slots and mortises and all that stuff. It's almost like a multi-router. So this is a plug cutting set, and this is cool. I don't think I have a plug cutting set, so I grabbed it. This is a the wood line set, so you know the quality of wood line. It's not, you know, great, but it's better than, you know, nothing if you don't have one. This guy here, I mean, that's just a nice set of four-piece, although it says five. Four-piece quick connect starter, central pneumatic, of course, Harbor Freight. But those are great. You need those for all your pneumatic tools. And the bad boy here. So this is the Jointech with look at that, all those guys right there. And I'm pretty excited about this. I think I've mentioned in some videos how excited I am about having this. This is a great thing to have. To see it in this shape, I mean, I am so stoked. This goes from telling you all about what you have purchased, right? Optional accessories, tells you what comes with it. Okay, so this is what I have. This set right here is what he had, so this is what I have. And the only thing that I don't have with this is the instructional video, and I have one blank insert, but it says it came with four. I only have one. Other than that, I have everything. So it's a complete set. So it's pretty impressive.